Today we are going to study the theory of supply. As we have discussed earlier, demand. So while discussing demand, जैसे demand पढ़ते time हम लोगों ने consumer को दिमाग में रखा था, इसी तरीके से supply पढ़ते time we have to keep in mind the producer. We have to think according to a producer. Producer को ध्यान में रखते हुए we'll study the different concepts of supply. कि producer जब supply करने पे आता है तो वो क्या-क्या factors consider करता है और उनको consider करने पे वो कितनी supply करता है quantity कितने product को market के अंदर sell करने के लिए ready हो जाता है. So starting with the topic supply, while studying supply we have to take all these 5-6 things in mind and while defining supply, जब भी supply की definition हम लोग देंगे, basically in general terms supply is what the producer is giving in the market. एक commodity का जितने भी quantities producer market के अंदर बेचता है एक different prices के ऊपर, that is the supply of that particular commodity. So moving ahead towards the definition of supply, we'll start with, it is a table or a schedule, tabular presentation होती है जिसके अंदर we are showing various quantities of a commodity, जिसके अंदर हम different quantities देते हैं एक ही commodity की, which the producer is willing to sell. जो एक producer market के अंदर sell करने के लिए ready होता है at different prices and at a point of time. Different prices के ऊपर different quantities कितनी units वो उस commodity की sell करने के लिए market में ready होता है at a particular point of time, that is known as the supply of that particular commodity. So summarizing the definition of supply, supply is a table or schedule showing various quantities of a commodity which a producer is willing to sell at different possible prices at a particular point of time. So this is the definition of supply. While studying supply we have different factors of supply, and जैसे डिमांड के साथ में बहुत सारे फैक्टर्स थे उनको स्टडी किया था हमने, वैसे ही सप्लाई के साथ में भी बहुत सारे फैक्टर्स हैं विच वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी थ्रू इट. बट बिफोर दैट वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सप्लाई शेड्यूल्स. नाउ सप्लाई शेड्यूल आर ऑफ टू टाइप. वन इज इंडिविजुअल सप्लाई शेड्यूल एंड अनदर वन इज मार्केट सप्लाई शेड्यूल. सो व्हाट इज एन इंडिविजुअल सप्लाई शेड्यूल? इंडिविजुअल सप्लाई शेड्यूल का मतलब है कि अगर हम बात करें कि एक इंडिविजुअल प्रोड्यूसर different प्राइसेस के ऊपर कितनी क्वांटिटीज अपनी कमोडिटी की मार्केट के अंदर सेल करता है, व्हेन वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट वन इंडिविजुअल प्रोड्यूसर, सो इट इज इंक्लूडेड इन इंडिविजुअल सप्लाई शेड्यूल. एंड व्हेन we'll club all the single individual producers, जब अलग producers को हम club कर देंगे, suppose firm A, firm B, firm C, ये तीन ही firms है market के अंदर जो एक particular commodity को एक particular product को market के अंदर sell करती है, तो ये तीनों firms मिलाकर कितनी commodity sell कर देती है एक particular price के ऊपर, that is known as market supply schedule. So individual supply schedule we are talking about a single producer. So we'll take price and quantity supplied of X commodity. So if the price is 100, 120 and 150, the quantity supplied will increase 12 and 15. Suppose, and here comes the relationship between price and quantity supplied. सबसे पहली जो चीज प्रोड्यूसर के दिमाग में आती है कि वो किसी भी कमोडिटी की कितनी क्वांटिटी मार्केट के अंदर सेल करेगा, द वेरी फर्स्ट डिटरमिनेंट ऑफ सप्लाई इज प्राइस, क्योंकि प्रोड्यूसर इज डूइंग व्हाट ही विल गेट फॉर द कमोडिटी इज द प्राइस ऑफ दैट कमोडिटी. वो जब मार्केट के अंदर अपनी कमोडिटी को बेचेगा तो उसको उसकी प्राइस ही मिलेगी. सो द बेसिक डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ सप्लाई इज प्राइस. So while studying the individual supply schedule or market supply schedule, we show the relationship between price and supply. So the relationship between price and supply is positive relationship, which means कि अगर price बढ़ती है तो producer जो है वो अपनी supply को भी increase कर देगा, because if the price is increasing he'll get more of profit in that particular commodity. तो जैसे जैसे price बढ़ेगी वैसे वैसे supply increase होगा, अगर प्राइसेस डिक्रीज होती है तो सप्लाई भी डिक्रीज हो जाएगा. सो हियर वी आर शोइंग दिस रिलेशनशिप ओनली If the price is increasing 100, 120, 150, the quantity supplied is also increasing 10, 12 and 15. So this is for suppose of firm A. The A is an individual producer jo different prices pe itni quantity sell kar raha hai. And coming towards the market supply, we have to take the supply of individual producers. Individual producers ko jab hum include karte jayenge, club karte jayenge, price of commodity X, suppose 100, 120, 150. Here we are taking supply of firm A, supply of firm B, and this will be your market supply. So supply of firm is 10, 12, 15, 11, 12, 13. So while coming toward this, in market supply schedule, we are taking individual producers, individual firms ko hum add on kar rahe hain, aur wo dono firms, we are assuming here ki there are only two firms for that commodity in the market. So in dono firms ne milkar 100 rupees ki price pe kitni quantity sell ki hai, that will be the market supply of that commodity. So here it will be 10 plus 11, then 12 plus 12 and 15 plus 13. This will be your market supply of the particular commodity that we are taking X. So this is your individual demand supply schedule and this is your market supply schedule. While going towards this, we have taken a word quantity supplied and supplied. What is the difference between these two? Supply means it is a schedule which shows all the various possible combinations of price and supply. Jahan pe hum ek pura schedule dekhte hain, jahan pe different prices ke upar different quantity kitni supply ki jayegi, that will be supply. But when we are talking about quantity supplied, we are talking about a particular price. See, if I am talking about quantity supplied, so I am talking about at this price, how much quantity supplied it is? 10. Ki agar price at 10, 100 rupees, to producer jo hai, firm A ka, wo kitna produce, kitna sell kar raha hai market ke andar? 10. So it is a quantity supplied. When we are talking about supply, we are talking about the whole schedule, and quantity supplied is at a particular price.